talking about a confrontation that may have happened between school 12 officials and RPD over a surveillance video or picture. We're going to ask about that as well. Again, we're expecting this to start shortly. We're going to have the superintendent and the school board president.
Good evening, everyone. I want to first acknowledge the presence of my colleagues. I see Commissioner Shepherd here, Commissioner LeBron, and I'm certain that my colleagues that aren't here are discharging their other duties. But first, I want to tell the members of the press we appreciate your coming here today. Just a little housekeeping. We have a hard stop at 5 o'clock. Staff members have some other commitments, but we'll try to answer as many questions as we can. Before that, we believe it is appropriate to make a brief statement. I will begin by saying today I had to do something I never would have imagined I would have to do as a public servant. And I have served in many different capacities in my 3 decades in public service. This day was second only to talking to the Givens family on the passing of their daughter, Stephanie Givens. So Trayvon's death and the circumstances surrounding his death affected me in a personal and a professional way, particularly with respect to the events of today. I had to, along with my colleague, Commissioner LeBron, look a grieving mother in the eye and tell her that we had made a mistake, a grievous mistake, an unalterable mistake. We are here for one reason and one reason only, and that is to take full and complete responsibility for this young man's passing. Others may dialogue about what they did and why certain things happened, but today, at 131 West Broad Street, at 4:30, my job as president of the Board of Education is to communicate to you on behalf of my colleagues and everyone who works for the district that we are sorry. Even at this early stage of this circumstance, there are some facts that are not in dispute. We now know that at least 3 adults marked Trayvon present when in fact he was absent. It also brings me no honor, indeed it brings me great shame, to admit that we have reason to believe that some adults that are part of this system, that we all work so hard to protect children, apparently attempted to alter attendance records. As a result of those known facts, there is but one inescapable conclusion. The Rochester City School District failed young Trayvon. Our superintendent has prepared a more detailed statement regarding this tragic loss and these circumstances. And in conclusion, I offer this to his mom, Ms. Houston. I offer this on behalf of my colleagues to the entire community. We must do better. Barbara.